Is this still on? Okay, yes. Thank you, everybody. Thanks for coming out. It's great to be back in Pittsburgh, my favorite city in the country. And I'm sure you're going to love this program today. I wanted to say a few words. I think I'm taller than Pauline. Hold on one second. I wanted to say just a few words about the program. If you're not on social media, Pauline had asked me to create a short video explaining this program and why I put the two pieces together. And if you're not on social media, you probably haven't seen it. But these two pieces have a lot of mystical connections, the biggest of which is that Rachmaninoff himself performed both of them many times. And in fact, he wrote this sonata for himself to play on his first American concert tour, which was in 1909, and he wrote it alongside the third piano concerto, the very famous third piano concerto. He played this sonata in America at least a dozen times, including here in Pittsburgh at the Carnegie Music Hall. And there's a review, there's a newspaper review you can actually still read. You can go to the microfiche or whatever and like at the library and read it, okay? So he was here. And then he actually came and played with the symphony many times after that. And I don't think there's any recordings of those concerts, but if you look at the archives of symphony performances, he was performing here all the time. And then he became an American citizen and he recorded Carnival, and his acoustic, not piano role, recording of Carnival became one of the most famous piano recordings from that era, which was 1929. And so these two pieces hold a very special place in Rachmaninoff's own musical personality, and they also have something else in common, which is a little unusual, and that is that both of them are based on a musical cipher, or like a little code that's embedded in the piece that determines sort of the pitch content of the melodies and the music. And so in the case of the sonata, he used this old, this chant from the Gregorian times that they also had in Russian chant books. It's called the Dies Irae. It's from the Latin Requiem Mass. Do you recognize that at all? So that, actually, you hear that melody quoted at the very end of the sonata. But throughout, it's actually embedded in every little piece of the sonata. It's very interesting. And then in the case of the Schumann Carnival, he took the German musical alphabet and spelled out the word Asch, which is A, S, which is E flat, C, and H, which is B natural in the German musical alphabet. And this is the town of his first fiance, Ernestine von Fricken, and he arranged this musical cipher in three different ways to create a whole piece called Carnival. And every piece has some combination of those notes, and also in A flat. In the middle of Carnival, there's a movement called Sphinxes, which his wife, the most famous interpreter of his music, the great pianist Clara Schumann, said you should not play. It was, she thought it was too weird. And a lot of his her additions, she's like, she changed things because she thought it was too incomprehensible because he was a little bit eccentric. But Rachmaninoff did play Sphinxes in his recording, and he gave us the musical cipher for Carnival, and so I guess I'll do it today too. I'm going to take a break after Rachmaninoff and walk off. It's not really an intermission. I just need to take a little breath. And I want to tell you one more thing about the Rachmaninoff. It's quite long, but it's long like a Russian novel is long. If you think of Brothers Karamazov or Anna Karenina or War and Peace, what I mean is there is a lot of characters, like musical themes. There's a lot of them. And just like there's a lot of characters in War and Peace, okay, you got to keep track of all these people and how they change. And in the sonata, all these themes also, they change throughout the course of the piece and they are always being developed. And so there's a lot of action and there's a lot of epic things that happen. So I want you to think of it like a 19th century Russian novel, and I think that might give you some insight into the piece. So thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you.